waves ahead of the whistle are crowded to... together and made shorter, while the waves behind the whistle are spread out and made longer. This change in wavelength does not change the speed with which the waves travel, but it does change the number of waves that hit your ear in a second. So, as the train approaches you, more vibrations per second reach your ear, and you hear a higher pitch than you would if the whistle wasn't moving. And as the train goes away, fewer vibrations per second reach your ear, and the pitch you hear is lower than it would be if the whistle wasn't moving.
Jason.